Welcome back to the Gears and Tool channel. Today we're reviewing the Yeti 400 by Goal Zero, a solar battery. And I've had this battery for 3 years, and we're gonna take another look at it and see, after 3 years, has it held up well? Would I still buy it? We'll find out. Hey guys, I've had this Goal Zero Yeti 400 lithium for 3 years now, and it's held up pretty good, but I wanted to quickly go through the features with you and then do some tests so you guys can see just how well it's performing after 3 years of use. Would I buy it again? I'll let you know at the end of the video. Real quick, let's go over the size and weight of this. It's 16 pounds and is 11.26 inches long, 6.97 inches deep, and 7.48 inches tall. Right off the Goal Zero website, pretty exact. All in all, I think it's very easy to carry. You're not gonna be backpacking with this, but as far as throwing in the trunk, moving around the house, throwing in a camper or something like that, it's a perfect size, easy to carry, it's not gonna break your back. So what do we get in the 16 pound package? Well, we have two AC outlets, just like in your house. These outlets are rated for 300 watts continuous use or 1200 watt surge. So if you have like a motor or something like that, we're gonna put this to the test a little bit later, see if it lives up to those ratings after 3 years. Can it still sustain 300 watts of continuous power? We'll find out. Then you have the three USB ports, great for portable devices such as cell phones, iPads, battery packs, you know, anything that runs off a USB port, super useful. I will note that it doesn't have the USB-C under here, like the newer Yeti 200X does. That's kind of handy for some of your newer laptops and stuff, but hey, it's got three ports, I'm not complaining. It also has your cigarette style 12 volt adapter, very similar to what you have in a car. And you know, I haven't used that much, but it can be super helpful for people who have existing camping gear and stuff for the car, like inflators, mini refrigerators. A lot of your camping equipment in general runs on 12 volts. So this was smart on Goal Zero's part, because when you're not running through the inverter, you're not draining the battery, just having it in standby. So it's more efficient and you don't have any power loss. For example, when you turn the inverter on, you'll notice that the watt usage increases. So currently it's pulling 10 watts. So just sitting here, it's gonna drain when the outlets are being run. So that's why the 12 volt and the USB ports are so useful. You're not wasting a lot of energy for your lower powered devices. And then over here you have your solar input, which I'll show you guys in a little bit, but that's how you charge it with either the supplied battery charging brick, which is 60 watts, or from a solar panel or a couple solar panels, depending on what your setup is. And Goal Zero sells those, and I believe you can set up other third-party panels as well. I haven't personally done that, but I have some Goal Zero panels that we'll try it out with today. Okay, enough talking about the features on the front of the box. Let's go ahead and plug this thing in, show you how to charge it with the included wall adapter, 60 watt, and the solar panel that I have. And then we'll actually plug some devices in and see how it performs under load. There's two ways to charge this Yeti. One's with the included power adapter, which charges the Yeti at 60 watts. Right now it's showing 61 watts. And then the other is on solar. Okay, here we have the Yeti plugged into the solar system. And I just wanted to point out that I have an extension cord going out the door, a 30 foot extension cord. And I'm gonna put a link in the description below. But the reason I do that is down here in Arizona, you know, for example, today it's gonna be 109 degrees outside. It's just really too hot for a battery pack like this to be sitting outside in that kind of heat. An added benefit is if you're on a campsite or something like that and you're not there, you can lock the battery, the more expensive part of your setup, inside while the solar panel sits outside like this, collecting energy. This is the Boulder 100 briefcase style solar panel that I'm using, and it works pretty well with the Yeti battery pack. I'll be doing a review on this in a future video. A lot of people buy a battery pack such as this so they can charge their portable devices on the go. Let's say you're a photographer, maybe you fly drones for a hobby, or you know, whatever you might be doing that would be away from a convenient power source. Something like this appears to work great for portable devices. I mean, right now we have a laptop, an iPad, and a battery pack plugged in, and we're pulling about 59 watts. This battery pack can do rate up 300, so no problem. How about a rice cooker? Okay, I admit we're getting a little outside the scope of what this thing was designed for, but hey, let's see what this thing can do. It's on warm right now. It's pulling 30 watts. Let's turn it to cook and see what happens. And it is working. We are pulling 324 watts and it has not tripped yet. Remember, 300 watts is the listed maximum of this battery pack. So let's just give it a few minutes, see if this thing will hold up. I mean, it's pulling 325 watts. You can hear the fans just kicked on. Oh yeah, it's pushing some air. Just go ahead and... moving a fair amount of air. Not hot air though, it's just kind of warm. Still running. So I would say, based on this, pulling 325 watts, this battery is definitely capable of doing 300 watts 3 years after it was made. That's pretty impressive if you ask me. Okay, well that was rather unexpected. I honestly thought the rice cooker would do the Yeti 400 in, pulling over 300 watts, but it's been over 5-6 minutes here and it's still going. I can see a little steam starting in that rice cooker, so the fans seem to be keeping it at a temperature where the battery can keep powering the device. So let's try something else. Okay, the Yeti powered the rice cooker. What about a drill press? Okay, I know, we're being a little ridiculous here, but on YouTube, people just show what these things can do. They never let you know what the limitations really are. So this is a 13 amp drill press. Look at the motor on the back of that. Let's give it a try. Nope. So the light just turned red. We tripped the breaker. So that's not unexpected, but now we know. Thanks for watching. If you guys enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe below. And I do a lot of product review videos and also do-it-yourself videos, which might be great for this current quarantine. If you have some time, I got some little do-it-yourself projects that you can check out. See you next time.